Yeah, but you got to remember, 81% of those fans thought that Y2J was going to get speared at all. Look out! They were wrong!
And the fans on their feet! The Texas Rattlesnake!
He's here!
Stone Cold and Bischoff present Bad Blood in the great state of Texas! Stone Cold's backyard this Sunday in Houston! And what an ovation!
To find out who that special referee is going to be.
It's my pleasure right now to introduce one of the toughest opponents I've ever faced in that ring.
Oh boy.
And the only man crazy enough and sick enough to referee the Hell in a Cell match. I'd like to introduce you to the hardcore legend, Mick Foley.
It's him! Mick Foley! It is Mick Foley! Oh my gosh! It is him! Mick Foley's here! Michael Francis Foley! Mrs. Foley's baby boy! Knows all about Hell in a Cell!
Thank you very much. As it turns out, Mrs. Foley's little boy has come back home.
In a big way.
You see, there were times I could have sworn I was done with wrestling, that I never stepped foot back in a WWE ring. But the truth is, you can take Mick Foley out of the WWE, but you can't take the WWE out of Mick Foley.
Welcome home, Mick.
And so, when I sat at home last Monday night watching Raw, as I always do, and I heard Stone Cold Steve Austin talk about the one man who was sick enough, the one man who was wild enough to referee the Hell in a Cell, I got goosebumps all up and down my arm. And I said to myself, please, Steve, please, let it be me, let it be me. And when the phone rang, and I looked at caller ID, and I see Austin Steve, I got on the phone, and I said, hell yeah, I'll referee the Hell in a Cell.
Hell yeah!
Because you see, I get in my car, and I drive around the country, and I talk to little kids. I talk to them about reading. I talk to them about bullying. I talk to them about helping out little kids overseas. And then when I say, are there any questions, all the hands go up and all the hands say, tell me what it was like to be thrown off the Hell in a Cell. Now they don't remember the match because I won, because I did not win. They remember the match because with a dislocated jaw, with a dislocated shoulder, cracked ribs, bruised kidney, gaping hole underneath my lip, front tooth sticking out of my nose, I got up and I walked out of that ring under my own power.
It was amazing.
And this Monday night, that's all I need to do. You see, no matter how bad it gets between Triple H and Kevin Nash, no matter what kind of hell is unleashed, and believe me, there will be hell unleashed. At the end of the match, the only thing I need to do is to take this right hand in the air, hit the mat three times, and count one, two, three. One, two, three. One.
Well, I think business has just picked up. I knew he wasn't going to be happy. The world's heavyweight champion, Triple H. A man that the man that retired Mick Foley about 3 years ago inside Hell in a Cell. In that very Hell in a Cell that we're looking at right now.
I got a feeling I might see you here tonight, Mick. Let me make something clear for you. This does not concern you. What's happening around here right now is none of your business. The reason it is none of your business is because you are no longer a wrestler, Mick. You see, you are just an ordinary guy. You live an ordinary life. You live in an ordinary home with an ordinary wife. You are just like all these idiots here. You are just a regular guy. I may be wrong, I may be hearing things, but I've only got the one ear. But it sounds to that one ear as if these fans are calling you an asshole. Oh. Maybe that's because they don't like the fact, Mick, that the reason you're a regular guy is because I made you a regular guy. February 27, 2000, Hell in the Cell, I retired Mick Foley.
Yes, you did, Triple H. Yes, you did. You retired Mick Foley. And believe me, you talk about it every chance you get. That's what you did do. What you did not do, what you could not do, was keep me down. So February 27th, 2000, if you remember, Triple H, after I took the best that you could dish out, and your best was damn good, after I took everything you had, it was me walking out under my own power, blood on my face, tear in my eye, head held high, looking back with pride on 16 years in the business. And that's all I've got to do this Sunday. I've got to walk proud, lift my head up, go down on a mat, Triple H, and with this right hand, count 1, 2, 3.
You know, Mick, you've never been a real bright guy. And I'm sure that the 10,000 or so chair shots that you took over that 16-year illustrious career probably didn't help you any. So let me make this real simple for you. You need to reconsider your decision to referee this match between me and Kevin Nash at Hell in a Cell Sunday.
Reconsider? What do you mean reconsider?
Mick, you don't need to let people sway your decisions. You don't need to let people put you in a position to get hurt permanently. What you need to do is listen to reason. You need, Mick, to just say no.
Just say no?
Walk away from this match, Mick. Now, I'm gonna give you a little less than an hour to make the decision. And Mick, you had better make the right decision, or I swear to you, I will drag what is left of your ordinary ass down to that ring, and I will make this decision for you.
My God, God Almighty, what a chilling threat, what a chilling promise from Triple H to Mick Foley. Mick Foley's got to reconsider or they'll be held to pay tonight. I'd say Mick better reconsider or he's toast.
Nice to have you back, man.
Thanks, man.
I was just watching out there. I heard what Hunter said to you.
Yeah.
I'd love to see you ref Hell in the Cell. Do you need this? I mean, after everything you've done, you don't need to prove anything.
Wait, Spike, let me see. I think I see where you're going. You want me to step aside in Hell in a Cell?
Mick, I'm saying you're retired. You've got a beautiful family at home, man. You need to think about them.
I'll tell you what, I'm gonna think about them, and I'm gonna think about what you said, okay? And by the way, thanks a lot, Spike.